It is the stuff of superlatives. It is contained in the toughest iron in the world, Damascus steel. As the super black in space telescopes, we discover distant galaxies with it. But the supermatter can only be seen under the electron microscope. It is the carbon nanotube. Their discoverer is the nano expert Sumio Ijima. With colleagues Masako Yudasaka and Akira Koshio at his side, he developed an efficient method for manufacturing the wonder tube. Suddenly, I had discovered these carbon nanotubes, quite by accident.
It makes me happy to have found the carbon nanotubes, because it is an important technology for the future.
There are many methods to produce carbon nanotubes, and we've discovered one of the best. Carbon nanotubes are versatile. For example, they make the most powerful computers faster, or car bodies lighter and harder.
As an additive to other substances, it makes the mixture harder or more conducive, or much lighter, for example.
Carbon is very multi-talented, and it is the building block of all life. On our planet, there are over 10 million carbon compounds. Trees breathe carbon, and even humans are made out of this miraculous element. But by the mid-70s, there was no microscope that could see the structure of carbon. This is where Ijima's success story began. The electron microscope was first developed in Germany, and people have always dreamed of being able to see atoms. Before the beginning of the 70s, that wasn't possible. Then I invented the first high-resolution electron microscope. Just as technology moves forward, the resolution of the microscope was getting increasingly better. Today, individual atoms can be viewed. A crucial step in nano research. First, scientists discover no nanotubes, but so-called fullerenes, small, spherical carbon particles. Up to this discovery, carbon itself was only known in the form of diamond and graphite. Ijima continued his research on fullerenes. After years of experimenting with a microscope, he stumbled upon carbon's tiniest filaments, the carbon nanotube. The discovery was accidental, but in a way, it wasn't. I spent so much time using a microscope that the discovery was almost inevitable. Soon it was clear. Ijima had discovered a new type of carbon. By comparison, a pin is 5 million times larger than a carbon nanotube. Its structure resembles that of hexagonal honeycombs. This atomic arrangement makes the material 50 times harder than normal steel, and at the same time, as light as a feather. I was immediately curious, because the carbon nanotubes were so small and long. Soon, several theorists and other experts confirmed that we had found something very interesting. However, there was a problem. Ijima needed to use a highly toxic form of iron to produce the nanotubes. But because of the size, the research team wanted to use the nanocarbon in biomedicine in the future. And for that, it needed to be non-toxic. If successful, drugs could be administered with pinpoint accuracy, for example. The researcher team needed to find a new, more efficient production process. We researched for 5 years. At the beginning, we used carbon powder and metal for the experiments, but it did not succeed. Then we experimented for 2 years with a graphite pencil. Finally, it worked. It generated very pure carbon nanotubes in excellent quality. The researchers thereby discovered a much less toxic manufacturing process. Using gas and a laser, the smallest carbon strands at the top of a charcoal stick were dissolved at 1200 degrees. They then accumulated on a cooled collector. These new carbon nanotubes were easier to separate from toxic residues. In 2011, the team patented their process. Now, researchers worldwide could start looking for ways to apply this miracle element to the field of biomedicine.
Carbon nanotube の中には毒性が低いものがあります。で、そういうものは医療用に有効だろうというふうに。
The less toxic carbon nanotubes can play an important role in medicine in the future. You could carry drugs directly to the cancer cells or use them to help you find the tumors, and they could quickly detect illnesses in blood tests.
It's an invention that will save lives in the future. As early as next year, it's predicted that the industry will see a turnover of almost 1 billion euros. Thanks to their discovery, the research team is one of the finalists for the European Inventor Award. It's a huge surprise and a nomination I did not expect. That makes me happy.
I'm pleased with the nomination because our carbon nanotubes are very promising. And I hope that they will prove to be a great service to humanity.
We'll see if Ijima's team can take home the coveted trophy at the 10th Annual Award Ceremony this year in Paris.